Well, surely as a country we have enough on our plates right now, what with the divisive carbon tax issue, the asylum seeker dilemma and the like. Now we're being warned that industrial warfare could be about to rear its ugly head again. On a couple of important fronts, trouble is certainly brewing, and we're being warned that that could spark a whole new era of industrial unrest. Here's Danny Isdale.
A key election promise of the Rudd government, Work Choices, was out and the Fair Work Act was in. Almost 2 years later, it's under pressure.
This is, I think, the latest stage in the evolution of Australian industrial relations where standards are set.
And limits are tested. While it's a long way from the violent scenes of 1998, today wharves in Sydney, Brisbane and Fremantle were again hit by industrial action. After negotiations broke down, Patrick Stevedores closed its container terminals, staring down work restrictions from the Maritime Union.
We've asked each of our employees as they've come to work today whether they're prepared to work without bans or limitations. None of the employees were.
We will go to the bargaining table and we will negotiate within the frames and the laws of Fair Work Australia.
So on the waterfront, the fight continues, and in the skies, another is brewing. Qantas pilots have now joined the company's engineers in a showdown with management, planning their first industrial action in 45 years.
We do so now because we are concerned not only for the future of Qantas pilots, but for the future of Qantas itself.
Dr. John Buchanan, one of Australia's leading IR researchers, has been watching both battlefronts closely.
Why do you think we're seeing so many IR flare-ups across so many different sectors now?
I think we're seeing disputes in these key sectors now because the economy's running quite strongly. We've got a new Industrial Relations Act. A round of leading agreements are expiring, and I think many employers are keen to test the limits and see what they can get away with and what they can't.
Then, of course, there's the unions trying to prove their relevance.
So after being pounded for many years under the Howard government and told they were irrelevant, they now have an act which says they deserve recognition and support, and I think they're going to want to show that pretty vigorously, that they are making a difference.
And this would be just the beginning.
And we haven't seen, you know, a full round of bargaining yet in manufacturing or in construction. When that comes through, then we could see a lot of colour and movement. You've got very well organised unions in the health and education sectors, and we haven't seen any really big disputes out of there yet. So it is conceivable that there could be more turmoil than we've had in the past, but with a far more limited capacity of the Commission to do anything about it.
Let's hope it's not a back to the future scenario.